people might have a different way of doing this, but I, this is on sale at 30 kilo bags, $5 at Home Depot. Lots of grunting. Long bit. I need it because it's down about 4 feet. Anyway. I just put this stuff in layers. Add a bit of water. Mix. Like, there's no need to, you know, put it in a wheelbarrow and shovel it in. Yeah, I'm sure somebody will say, yeah. But this works just fine. Fuck off. Well, I mean, excuse me. Well, there it is. Done. It's a good thing I bought that extra bag, that fifth bag. Anyway, I'll just let that sit for a while. Okay, that's back-to-back welded unistrut. It's got a lot of engineering in it. I remember first seeing it in 1980. I believe it was around for a couple of years before that. And, yeah. That's the pole. And then there's a 20-footer back-to-back welded strut where my windmill's going on. And a security light. It's a 12-volt. Brand new LED outdoor 1200 lumens, 12 volt, you know, it's just... Okay, well, as you can see, it's laid and set in there. And, put a boat winch. The strut pivots. Hard to see in the daytime here, but I think it's a little higher. Right there. Look up, way up, and I'll call the wind. Holy man. Yeah, it's up there. There, up there. I like it when an idea works the first time. May have to change that. Well, it looks like I might cheat myself out of some sun with that pole there, but you know, it's just not that many preferable locations. You know. Anyway, it just, I'm sure that when the wind's blowing through there, it's gonna make a positive impact anyway, so doesn't seem to be hitting it this time of the year, but it will. Anyway, afterthought.